G'day, welcome to Farming Live Australia. Today I'd like to talk with you about different income streams you could have on your small farm or homestead. While I'm talking with you about this subject, I'm not going to just be standing here talking. I'm actually going to be building a cage for our baby chickens because they've got too big for the little area that I've got them in, and I want to get them out on the grass. All right, well, without further ado, let's get right into it.
When I talk about income streams, I'm not going to talk about off-farm jobs much. The only off-farm things I will talk about much is selling or bartering things you've made or produced at home and taken somewhere else to sell or barter. Your location has a lot to do with what opportunities are open to you to make extra money and have extra income streams. For instance, if you live in a cold climate and have access to lots of timber, say you were clearing your block and it had lots of trees you had to get rid of that were on the ground or whatever, instead of just picking it up and burning it, you could cut it up and sell it as firewood. In the tropics where we live, this is not really much of a possibility because people just don't want firewood. However, you can turn the firewood into biochar, and people do want that. Where we live, I'm not talking about cutting down the trees and making biochar out of it. I mean the stuff that's on the ground from natural disasters, or even just the stuff that falls down out of limbs of the trees. We just have a huge amount of biomass that we can burn that we have to get rid of anyway. Even lantana that we clear can be turned into biochar, and that turns a negative into a positive. In remote areas where we live in, we are a bit more restricted because we don't have access to the public. Markets aren't close, so growing vegetables or something like that and taking them to the market's not really a financial proposition. We don't have any passing traffic either. However, having said all that, we do have a computer and a phone, and this opens up all sorts of possibilities. When COVID struck, a lot of people saw that as, you know, the end of their income. But in fact, I know some people that their income just went through the roof, particularly a couple of different people I know with roadside stalls. They just absolutely killed it because people saw the roadside stall as an alternative to having to go to the supermarket. They thought they probably weren't very likely to have to come into contact with other people. And a lot of those people I know have actually done really well out of that situation. You are really only limited by your ability to look outside the box and think up ways of making new income streams. One fair question is, why would you even bother to have lots of income streams? Why not just get into something like, say, growing tomatoes? Focus on that and just rely on that. The problem I see with that sort of thinking is that you're very reliant on one market, and if that market crashes or you can't grow the tomatoes or whatever, then you have no income at all. Lots of small income streams means that if one dies, you're not left with no income whatsoever. And usually small income streams don't cost you a lot of money to set up. One income stream that we have is growing hay. It works out really well for us because we have cattle and they go hand in hand. I mean, if we couldn't sell the hay, it'd be quite easy for us just to put it down the throats of our cattle. But so far, we've never had this situation crop up. We're usually looking for it, not at it. One thing against the hay growing exercise is it's really expensive to get into to do it on any sort of level where you can be competitive. One thing with hay growing and everything that you do as an income stream is you have to be very, very careful of your costs and know exactly what things are costing you and constantly doing your sums to see if it's worthwhile or not. The other thing with our income streams that I've done over the years is not just rely on income streams that can be done on the farm. And some people may not want to do that, and that's fine. The reason I do that is because if we had a really dry time or, you know, the market was completely buggered, I could still make a bit of money to put food on the table and keep the wolf from the door with something outside of farming. And I guess it depends on what you like to do. Well, you know, I've got a few things online that I do. Not all of them very successful. One in particular that's not real successful is YouTube. For the amount of effort and energy and hours I put into it, it's the worst earner I've got. However, having said that, I do have some others which do actually make a little bit of money all the time, and they're passive income. There's things that I don't have to work at all the time, and even if they only make a dollar here and there, at least I'm not working on it very many hours of the day. I spoke about income not off the farm, and what I meant by that was income that wasn't made from farming. I didn't mean that it wasn't conducted on the farm necessarily. Some people who watch my channel all the time will realise that I do sculpture as well, and that's been pretty successful for us over the years. And I do that on the farm. I build sculptures on the farm and I sell them in all sorts of places, mostly nowadays by commission. I don't really go out there looking for it anymore, it finds me. Initially, of course, I had to get recognised and, you know, get a market and put stuff here and there for sale. I don't tend to do that anymore. I tend to do really big pieces and people look for me and get me to do them. And that's a pretty unlikely sort of a thing. I didn't in my wildest dreams when I started that think it'd be very much. I thought it'd be just pretty, you know, maybe make a few bucks here and there, but that's about it. But it actually turned into probably one of the biggest earners I've had over the years of everything I've done. I understand that everyone's not an artist and, you know, we're all different, but we all have our own strengths. And I guess you need to look at what your strengths are and what you can do and what services you may be able to provide to people and exploit them and turn it into an income. Really, I think what limits most of us is our ability to sit down and really think up good ways of making all different sorts of income. Most of us just do what we know how to do, and at that point we just call it a day. And that's fine, you know, if you just want to spend, you know, 40 hours a week in a job, and as well as that, do your little farm on the side and grow, have a few chooks and grow a few veggies, there's nothing wrong with that. The trouble is you've only got to get the sack and your whole world falls apart. Having multiple income streams is like an octopus losing a leg. It's not going to kill the octopus. He doesn't feel very well for a while and it might be a bit of a battle, but he does get through it. And eventually he'll grow another leg perhaps. To sum up, today with the computer and phones, I think the possibilities are endless. I think the main thing, no matter what you choose to do, if you decide to go with multiple income streams, is to really do your research and make sure that the figures add up. Because if they don't add up, then it just doesn't make sense. If you want to be part of the conversation regarding income streams for small farms or homesteads, please put a comment in the comment section or email me. Thanks a lot for watching this video of Farming Live Australia. I'll see you next time.